So look who also works. Just had a little ride around the block on the Curries of the Elizabethan. It's just the second or third bike of three, depends on which order I put the videos out. But this is the day after pickup. All I've done is put the pedals on, put some air in the tyres and come out. I often tend to do that. One day I'll break something by doing it. Anyway, here we are. Stormy Archer twist grip. The type of brake levers that are seen on some rallies, particularly on Moultons, that kind of brake lever. I was looking for one for someone for a Moulton the other week, and then he found one. But I love the finish on these bikes. I love the billiard cue. I think that is so cool. And another link to early Moultons there, if you know your Moultons. And the colour is quite orangey, but it's actually just a fade from, with UV over years. Mr. D's other one is quite orange, but this is actually the usual Raleigh Royal Carmine, however you want to pronounce it. So it's quite a red usually. So what is to report? Well, wheels are good and true and taut. The Raleigh front hub runs nicely. Stormy Archer hub performs impeccably. Bottom bracket is a little bit, just a little bit stiff on the freewheel. The brakes are actually working better than the Superb. Although it does need new pads in. So they'll come off and get a refurb as well. It's going to have a chain case, obviously. I'll come to that later with colours and things. It's going to have a suitably aged B66 Brooks saddle, either black or brown, depending on what I've got. I'm not buying one in. I would have thought black grips, but I can't change the grip colour because of the twist grip gears. I do have a black twist grip, but I don't want to mess about with it because this one's working nicely. So that grip colour will do fine. What is going to be changed is the cable colour. These are original 1960s ribbed cable housings. You can't get those now and people need them, so I will take those off and clean them up. But I want to put black cables on it. I don't like the white cables on the black and red bike. Speaking of which, the forks are not staying grey. I'll discuss that in a minute as well. Lights. Do I want to put lights on it? Maybe, maybe not. I might put a basket on the front since it hasn't got lights. No, I won't, because that will hide this. And you wouldn't want to hide that, would you, really? So no, I won't put a basket on. So I might put a headlight on, something suitable. It would have had, if it had been equipped with the dynamo, it would have had the sports model Stormy Archer, same as the Raleigh Riviera. I might have one of those, not sure. But I'll put something nice on. I do have a black bodied Superb style, you know, the traditional Raleigh headlamp. I've got one of those with a black body. That would go nicely on it. And of course a little teardrop rear light and some kind of bottle dynamo from the period. I think I'd like to do that. A carrier, I'm getting too many bikes without carriers these days. So yes, I'll put a suitable carrier on. The hub date is 65.5, so that's May 1965. So I can put a suitably 60s carrier on it. That's an interesting brake shoe there. Just to cut down on the vibration, obviously. Allow it to bang on there instead. And there's a little clip on here as though it had wire, as though it had a wire for a dynamo. But I think that clip is meant to go on there so that doesn't hit the paintwork. Anyway, it'll be getting new pads, just not actual shoes. But I'm inclined to keep these shoes now. Presta valves better than Woods valves, but do I want them? I don't know. And obviously it's got accessory pump pegs on, so I can adjust those and put whatever pump I want on. A black pump would be fine on this bike. I don't really have much that, for which a black pump would be suitable. But yeah, I think it does need a carrier, don't you? It's going to be nice, this one. I've just got a soft spot for them. You know, it's heart over head. There's no reason why I should have a particular soft spot for the Elizabethan. I just do. Since I got that two-tone green one, I didn't really know them then. And that was so nice, and the quality was there as well. Not like when Raleigh usually made a sub-brand that wasn't for sale at Raleigh dealers. Sure, you got the frame quality, but it was down-specced. Whereas this, I think, was a bike that they were building for Currys, not to be sold by Raleigh. This was just a subcontract job, as far as I know. So spec will have been agreed at meetings, I suppose. And looking at that billiard cue paint job and the mudguards and such, they obviously wanted a premium bike. And I think they got it. I think it's absolutely lovely. I'm looking forward to repairing the issues. And this will probably be a keeper. I found that the bottom bracket is a bit stiff. There is no oiler on it, so therefore I will do it with grease. There is a slightly loose cotter pin, and the cranks are not parallel. Notice they're Raleigh cranks, by the way, but they're not parallel. One cotter pin's been put in the wrong way around and it's worked loose. Also, threading the left-hand pedal in, it kept trying to cross-thread itself, and it now feels a bit strange. It's got that weirdness as you pedal, whereas the outside of your foot is doing that as you're pedaling. So I think that crank is knackered. This crank is a little bit the same. I think it's maybe been dropped on this crank and it's bent slightly. That can be addressed. Gears work beautifully. The twist grip is smooth as silk, very nice. It's got a lovely solid feel on the road. The handling with those long offset forks is lovely. The tyres are not the best, of course, so some good tyres on it will improve the ride. The saddle's horrible, but that doesn't matter, it's coming off. So yeah, there's some traces of white tail on there, traces of white paint. So me putting a white tail on will not be detracting. It's been, being a proper rally frame, it's been bonderized. That's the black that's underneath almost every metallic or every paint job on a rally. Starts with the black bonderized dip. And it really was good stuff. So, the colour is the Raleigh Royal Carmine that is on everything from the 1950s through to the 70s. That Raleigh metallic red. It's Royal Carmine. Some of this has faded a little bit orangey. So I'm making it a mission now to find that colour. I think there is a Renault colour. I had a Renault Espace that was Rouge de Fer, fire red. That was probably not far off. And there is a more modern Renault parked around the corner in a really bright, quite startling version of it. But that's probably to do with the three-stage application. It'll be a translucent top layer over some bright silver or something. Or gold, that's how they do it. It's how the flamboyant colours on a lot of lightweight bikes of this period used to be done. And so you would see on the top tube, for example, you'd see the colour worn away to grey or white underneath. And that's what they've done. So I'm going to try and find paint for this and the Boulevard Tourist. And when I take a trip down to Mr. D's collection, with his mudguards for his red Riviera, I can give that a couple of touch-ups as well if he wants me to. When I find it, I will publish the numbers for it. Oh, that's nice. I've just noticed this. What's he just noticed? There he is. Elizabethan by Curry's. The Elizabethan by Curry's. That's nice. Now, when I'm finding paint, that doesn't mean I'm going to respray the whole bike. I'm just going to tidy it up. And mostly, I'd like to do the forks. I will do the forks black for the time being, because I hate that look, the grey on there, I just hate it. So, when I do the refurb on this bike, I will paint the forks black if I haven't got some red paint by then. I'd like to put a chain case on, because it does have, as I've said, the boss for the chain case, so it's effectively a superb frame. Maybe just a black chain case until I can find the red, so that I get one on it. And of course I want better cranks on it. Wheels are fine. Hub is fine, as I've said. Bottom bracket just not as loose as I would like. But I have to say that has loosened off as I've gone around the block on the bike just now. But obviously I will be taking that out, sluicing it out and relubing it. So there we have the Elizabethan. It's going to be a nice little restoration series, this one, I think. I didn't really get a chance to do a restoration series on the green one because it didn't need much, so you just saw the recommissioning video. This will go a little bit further. So thanks for watching, and I hope you join me for the restoration of the Elizabethan alongside its stable mates. Bye-bye now.